Hey guys, welcome back to this channel. Today we are going to see how to make this awesome looking material UI design form with the help of HTML and CSS only. So without wasting much of your time, let's get to the code. So let's begin with the HTML first. The usual declaration of HTML, giving the link to our CSS. Then I'm creating the division for the entire box which will be placed in the middle, and then I'm dividing that div into subparts, which is the left part and the right part. So in the left part we first have a text, after that we have an image, and then we again have a text plan accordingly, and below that we have two horizontal lines. These horizontal lines are made by the HR tag. Now in the second part of the div, first I have a heading for login. And after that I'm creating another div inside which between the form tags I'll be taking the inputs from the user in their respective text fields, like username we have text and password, the type is password. So, and then creating a button for submitting it, and then a link for a forgot your password using the anchor tag. So this finishes our HTML part. Now without CSS it's not going to look at all good. Let me just show you. See, no fun, right? Now let's begin with the fun part, the CSS. So let's start with the body first. First I'm setting an image, the background, and then I'm making sure that it doesn't repeats, that is only one image is there which covers the whole screen. And I'm setting the margin and padding to 0. Now in the container, which is the box we will have in the middle, I'm setting its position to absolute, the top and left to 50%. For now I'm making the background white, it doesn't matter because we are going to overlap the other colors on it. And by this transform translate -50%, -50%, which means that we are dragging that container to the middle of a screen. The -50%, -50% are the X and Y coordinate of it on the screen. And keeping the opacity to 0.9 so that we can see a little bit of the background. And the other thing, like with we can choose depending upon our login form, like a login form doesn't need much of a space, only username and password, but for registration form we might need to take more details, so we might have to change the width and height. That totally depends upon you. Next is giving the padding 0, a bit of a border 1 pixel solid, and a box shadow which will be at the bottom layer and the right layer of it, so that it gives a good look. So now the container is set. Let's now focus on the left part. I'm keeping the padding to 0, margin to auto, giving the width of 50%, and height same of the container, which is 450 pixels. Float to left, which means that all the contents will be floated to the left part. The background color is 1 RGB value. This gives the greenish color to it. So now moving ahead with the text, giving it a colored white, font size to 30 pixels, giving it a padding towards the top and the left end so that the text doesn't stick to the margin. And same for the image, we don't want the image sticking to the edge, we want it in the middle. So I'm using this display to block and margin as auto. So this will set the image to the center. See, looking nice now. Now giving the width, color, margin bottom to the HR so that the line is pretty visible and it looks good. First line is like 70%, second is 50%. And lastly, styling the last line, plan accordingly. So now moving towards the right division, keeping the padding to 0, margin to auto, the width is 50% and the height is same, 450 pixels. And for this, the float is to right and the background color is the RGB value which we have for that particular color. Now styling the login text, we are just aligning it to center and the color has changed to white. Now let's see about the last division box, where all our user inputs are present. So first, the width is given 100%. The padding is 040 pixels, which means the top padding is 0 and the right padding is 40 pixels. Box sizing to border box and the height is 400 pixels. Now this is for the username and password text. Changing color to white, margin bottom is 10 pixels and font size is changed to 20 pixels now. Now for all the input fields, I'm keeping the margin bottom to 20 pixels, width to 100% and font size to 18 and color to white. Now let's change the look of the box to a single line on the input field so that the border is made to none. The outline is also given none. But if you'll refresh, you will see that the border is still present. For that, just make the background to transparent. And there it is. Now you won't see any sort of border or outline to it. Now changing the border bottom to 2 pixels solid and white color. Now this will give a white line at the border bottom only. Yeah, this looks good. So now on the focus event, we want to change the border to the green color which we have on the left side. So for that, I'm going to use this colon focus, and in this I will change the border bottom to 2 pixels and the color will be now the green color. And also to make it look like more attractive, I make a transition of 0.5 seconds with ease in out so that it looks pretty good now. So now let's begin the styling of the button, keeping the width to 100% and height to 40 pixels and changing the background color to the green color and the text to the white. Keeping this letter spacing to 2 pixels so that there is a little space between the letters login, and the font weight to bold and font size to 20 pixels. Changing the border radius to 5 pixels so we get a nice round curve around all the borders, and the cursor to pointer, which is that whenever the cursor goes into that login button, the pointer cursor changes to pointer. And now on the hover effect of the button, we will change the background color to white. There will be a slight border of 2 pixels of the green color, and the transitions will be of 0.3 second ease in out again, and the color of the text will be changed to the green color. So because of this, you will get to see this effect, which looks pretty good now, right? So now only one thing is left, which is your forgot your password link. So for that, I'll change the color to white so it's visible, and the text decoration to none, because of which the underline will be gone now. Yep, looking good now. And on the hover effect, let's change it color to that green. So that's it. In just 10 minutes, you got to learn this amazing looking form, and I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you did, please like, share and subscribe. And also, if there is some concept that I missed or you didn't understand, you can ask me in the comment section below. And stay tuned for more amazing videos. Thank you.